Hello, one and all. This is Luckless Lovelocks back with Dark Souls 3. Changed up my build quite a bit. We just beat the dancer, so I got her stuff with some of the souls that I got when looking around for stuff that we've missed. So I'm wearing the dancer's stuff, Wolf Knight Greatsword plus 3 again. Estus Ring, Farron Ring, so I can recover FP, because I'm going to use more FP. This episode, I think. Well, I'll try it out. Lloyd Sword Ring. Chloranthi Ring, so I've got some more stamina. And I readjusted my Estus. I'll need to rest to have it switch up. So it's plus 8, or sorry, it's 3 charges on FP, then 10 on regular Estus. And Ludlis said last time around, do not seek the boy because she knows her fate. What, I guess if we find her. So I guess she's lying to us that, or either that, or she really has the knowledge that's not been passed down from Firekeeper to Firekeeper what's going to happen to her if we find the boy. Very interesting stuff. As we move on in Lothric, which I want to do, I could spend more time looking for stuff we've missed, but excuse me, I feel like the things that we have missed, probably because we missed triggers, and I could look around forever and still not find things. So I'm gonna continue on because I really want to finish this game. We'll see how this build works out. Be fun. It's been a lot lighter of a build, and it'd make things more difficult. If it is more difficult, I'll probably switch it up. Okay, back to so strange coming back here. I'm gonna have to go to the Vort bonfire. And run through. Maybe I'll just spend a couple seconds trying out this build. Still can't get over how cool this looks. Sky, and also I noticed when I went down to the Undead Settlement before, there's an actual eclipse happening, which is the reason why the sky looks the way it does. So, defeating all the Lords of Cinder caused an eclipse to occur. I guess the Dancer was probably there the entire time, since I remember the description of the Vort said he's never far from the Dancer. And I'm assuming the Dancer is the one that killed the High Priestess. Breaks their poise right away. Let me just try this out. Range on that's not so good. One shot. We're doing lots of damage with this. I love the embered effect on this cape too. Do you guys see that? That's so cool. These guys will be a bit more of a challenge. Missed again. If you break their guard, you can get a crit. Takes a long time to swing this thing. Surprised there's no bonfire here, but guess maybe we'll find one up above. Still have it placed. Oh, there's a bonfire here. I just didn't light it. Is this the Dancer bonfire? Dancer of the Boreal Valley, okay. I went back and I actually looked at some of the footage from the distress test for Dark Souls 3. And it looked like this fight happened earlier on, and it was called Dancer of the Frost Valley. And where you fought the Dark Wraith is where they had a fight with one of the Outriders of Irithyll. So maybe that was just because they wanted to show off those types of enemies, because they're a bit different. But I don't know if that was, or if that was like a redesign. Gonna cut his head off. Very cool. I'm so excited, guys. I've been waiting to go up here for a while. Great. Praise the Despair. Lothar Castle. Just as I thought. I'm gonna try to avoid reading these messages. This is a shortcut. Oh. Really? Apparently we're stuck here. Well, John. John. Got hyper armor on that one. Okay. Good to know. Attacks are a bit faster than me. Yeah, it's gonna take some time to get used to trying to hit me with the medallion. Stop my healing. Why is that not doing damage? I guess like a narrow hit doesn't do damage. Cool, cool, cool. Nice. He's wearing that thrall mask that I keep picking up. Oh, cool. We got. Okay, we got an Ash Nest last charge. Okay. I don't know how it decides what to give you first. That fog wall should be gone. Dragon fight coming up? Okay, here are these knights that we encountered in the Cathedral of the Deep. Shield strikes always get me. Shit. Oh, nice, nice counter. No, I missed it. Oh no! hard. Things are gonna explode. Can't seem to get close enough to get the crit in, if I can. Sweet, 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 sweet. Okay, I'm getting used to this. I've been using a shield for so long, it's hard to get used to combat without the shield. Oh god, where is this taking me? Let's take a look. Okay, before I go down there, I want to see what's in the other direction. Tough enemy. Kind of tough. I guess they're talking about the invader. No. What? There's your wall ahead. Yeah, there's something up there. That is so weird. Now, Dark Souls 1. Yeah. Under 35 appraisals. It's got to be a clown. Roll. Whatever. I hit it. What I was gonna say is, in Dark Souls 1, there were in Ulysil, I think there were some illusory walls you could open up with carrying a torch. Not gonna read that. I'd rather see what happens here. So there's graves of fallen knights. It looks like one knight praying. Yeah, let's bring this guy out. I don't want to take on both of them at the same time. This looks like the one we took on before that was in the blue, wearing the blue cape. Guy hits hard. Holy shit. I mean, I don't have very strong armor on either. Casting some spell. Shit. Trying to control distance here. He's gonna heal him again. Doesn't want to come through here. I'm gonna take out the guy in the background. Build him up completely. Great. No! Oh no, you gotta be kidding me! It's funny because that was actually more of a fair fight with him alive. You don't want fair fights though, guys. Only a large titanite shard, but this is interesting. So what was he kneeling down to? It's a body here. No, it's not this sword. Crestfallen knight. Can't take this. Sword has some significance, obviously. It's a whole chapel built around it. Heroes of Lothric. Which way to go first? Spear Knight. Or healer? Yeah. You know what I. Oh. What I should be doing. Casting. Oh, I don't have the FP to cast Deep Protection. But there goes all my Estus, so using all my Estus on a few guys, not good. But I'm also getting used to this build. Okay, I got one back. So it gives you the regular Estus first. Okay, there's the healer. Kind of look like they're as hollow as the first enemies we encountered in the grave. Is there another enemy? Yeah. Okay, we attack a bit faster than them, which is good. Yeah, this looks like it's going up to the area that we could see before. Wait, are you alive? Yes. Almost look like a statue. Oh, perfect. Almost too perfect. Another sword. Is this just... Let me just look at the Lothric sword. It's the Claymore. Good. Here's the heavy Lothric sword. Oh, shit. Oh, it doesn't matter. Yeah, it's like the same style. Okay. I go too far here. Before I reset all the enemies. Oh, we can go back. That's the sword. Okay, that makes sense now. Funny, where do those spiral staircases go to? Like that one over there. Where's this supposed to go to? It appears to go to nowhere. Interesting architects. Interesting architectural style. Okay, I'm gonna continue along this way. Although that other path is seeming like, I guess I could drop down. This seems more like the main path. The other path seems to be more of a side path. Something. I feel like something's gonna drop down on us. But okay, this is what those healers are wearing. Prince Lothric's hood. Hood. The prince, destined to be a Lord of Cinder, was cherished by the royal family. Despite being born into illness, a frail and shriveled child, his swaddling clothes are made of aged, coarse cloth used in ancient prayer, and are all that he has ever worn. He's never changed out of them. So why are they here? Where's the robe? Did we not pick up a robe there? Oh, here it is, Prince Lothric's robe. Okay, same thing. And I think there was a skirt or something. Same thing. Like how the items just keep you moving forward, even though you might not want to. Titanite shunt. Oh, sweet. We need those. Back to these deserters. Lothric deserters. It's far into the game. That was, I don't know if you guys... Oh. There's, something flying around up there. Are those supposed to be like the skeletons of dragons? Creepy. They seem to have more HP though. Okay, where are we now? Let's see if we can find any landmarks. I think courtyard is down there. Holy shit. They're everywhere. Look at how many there are. More and more coming. There's the eclipse. There's something there that's gonna fall down on us. Spring the trap. Oh, one of these guys. Okay. Good. Thank you. Double axe. I don't know if their AI is scripted to like be more aggressive when you're low, or if it's just like my perception of the enemies, but it feels like it. Oh. How many axes you got, buddy? It's got some miracles there. Large Titanite Shard. Fuck, I don't know if I want to keep going up or if I want to go back down. Keep going up. I feel like I'm kind of committed. I don't, like, I'm not sure if I would have attacked this wall without that message there, but this does seem a bit strange. There's nothing here at all. Probably would have. Huh. This looks a lot like the soldier that we just fought, glorified in the painting. Actually, the one that we fought in the courtyard. Here's the stuff. Okay. Winged Knight. Armor of the Winged Knights, who swore themselves to the angels. Worship of the divine messengers was viewed as heresy in Lothric and unrecognized by any of the three pillars of rule. Three pillars of rule. I don't think we've heard that before. This is believed to be why Gertrude, the heavenly daughter, was imprisoned in the lofty cell of the Grand Archives. Is that where we are, the Grand Archives? Same thing. So, was there a civil war that happened here? Is there a weapon too? The one. So this is like, this is like a little secret area in the castle. Bloom shield. Treasured antique of the Way of the White, known to some as the Sorcerer's Bane. The large blossom design that graces the shield is said to be a sacred flame. It looks a lot like the rose window in kind of the cathedral where we fought the Dancer. High magic protection. Okay, Way of the White. Pretty cool. Magic defense. I have to remember that they're probably giving it to us here for one reason or another. Maybe there's going to be a magic fight coming up. We're up here. That. And then this is where. Okay, right. That's where we picked up the prince's stuff. I assume by the boy they mean Ludlithmet, the prince. Oh, I see you. Still got hit by him. Four chunks, nice. That's your trap? That's your trap. think I could jump down there, but I think it's death. Okay, there's messages down there. Where are they coming from? What is that? That's a mountain off the distance, right? Mountain. Those must be the angels. Another one? Oh shit! That's preventing me from healing. Let's wait for that to wear off. Ow! What? Where am I getting shot from? Yeah, there's someone up there. That was the guy that was up there. Yeah, these guys are way tougher than the deserters from before. I like this run, spinning move, and attacks at kind of just the right speed. Oh shit. That guy is annoying. Okay, it looks like he's moved. How do they get messages there? Messages floating around all over the place, guys. That is your... Oh, okay. That's the courtyard down there. That's the rose window. That's where we came in. That's where we fought the dancer. That's making sense now. Where are these guys headed? Looks like they're just kind of flying around up there. Okay. I'm gonna wrap up this episode here, guys. Thank you so much for watching. This is Luckless Lovelocks. Signing off for now, and I love you all.